called stress, but you being the student community, so we'll be talking about the exam stress. See, according to me, stress is nothing but created by our own selves, because when we have a lot to do and we don't know how to manage it, it creates stress. So I am going to highlight 3-4 areas according to my experience which are very relevant for your exam preparation, be it board exams, be it competitive exams, or be it life as a whole. If you are able to implement these areas in your life, you will be able to manage all kind of stress in your life, be it for studies, career, or otherwise. So let's see what are those points. I'll rank them according to my life philosophy. So the first and the foremost which hold importance according to me is the attitude. Attitude determines everything. In studies, in academics also, I'll say that we feel that more than aptitude, attitude is responsible for success or for failure. And this is such a beautiful word that if we see the English alphabets from A to Z and we assign a number 1 to A, 2 to B, 3 to C, so on and so forth, it adds up to a total of 100. You can later on check it for yourself. This is such a beautiful word which holds such an importance that it adds up to 100. Second point according to me, which is the most important in anybody's life, is discipline. This is a part of attitude according to me. If you don't have a positive attitude, a killing instinct in your life, you can never be disciplined in anything. Be it in getting up early or meeting deadlines or handling any kind of stress. Again, a very beautiful thing which applies to attitude applies to discipline also. It also adds up to a total of 100. So that is the importance of these two words in our daily lives, that if we are able to incorporate in our day-to-day things, we are definite to achieve success in whatever we are doing. Third thing which holds importance according to me is the planning. There is a very wise saying which says that if we are planning to fail, if we are failing to plan, then we are somehow planning ourselves to fail. So that means if we plan our work beforehand, if we plan our studies, be it for board or for competitive exams, and schedule our time accordingly, definitely we will be able to achieve the best as far as our potential goes. And the fourth point, last but not the least, which we hear every day from students, from parents, from us as adult professionals, is called time management. This is such a word that if we understand the fact that in a day they are going to be 24 hours only, however much we pray, however whatever we may do, these hours are not going to increase in any case. So if we accept this fact and plan our day accordingly, we will definitely be able to achieve the maximum. And according to me, again, time management is a very important part of planning. We should make very reasonable goals day-wise, week-wise, month-wise, and then we'll be able to plan our studies in a very beautiful way and achieve the maximum targets. So for today, I would like to wind up by saying that just for an experiment basis, apply these four principles in your life, in your daily things, in your routine tasks, and see the change in your output.